Today we are going to start using vuex, and after that we are going to implement what we did on the last episode with vuex stores. So let's go on our front-end and back-end and let's open the server. So on the front-end, npm run serve, and on the back-end, let me do that, sorry, okay, npm, actually php artisan serve, because we need to make requests to it. Vue CLI already installs vuex when on a default template, so basically we have, let's check the main.js, and here we have our store that it is imported from our store folder, and use it like vuetify. So basically on the store folder we have our index with a root module, let's say, or root state. So we could just use nested modules, or directly on the root we can have a global, let's say, or basically on the root level of state, mutations and actions. Vuex functions like that. So for example, we have actions that call mutations, and only mutations changes the state. So let's make an action. Actually, let's create a new module for our user, because right now we have our user module, or actually that's what we need to implement. So let's create a JavaScript file called, my bad, user.js, and inside this user.js we need to export default object that has state, mutations, actions and getters. Don't forget about getters. Getters is basically a function that returns a piece of state, a part or all of the state of that module, or just a property. We define them. Okay, so let's create a constant, for example, for our state, which is an object. So let's say that we have state here. Basically, we should have a isLoggedIn property, because we need to end with a false as default, because we need to know when a user it is logged in. So we will change this property when after the login function. Okay, so isLoggedIn and the user. Actually, the tokens, that we have the tokens on our local store. So the user details, maybe, which is an object, an empty object. We will complete this object when we have exactly all the data for our users. Okay, so state, we could have mutations, which is an object with functions. So for example, we have constant mutations. That is an object. So set logged in. So let's do that. So set logged in, it's a function that takes the state as a param and payload. The payload is basically what we are going to send for our state. So state that is logged in equals payload. Basically, we are setting the state of is logged in, and actions. Let's say that we are going to have an empty function for the moment. So let's put state, mutations, actions, and let's import on our index our user module. So we import user module from, my bad, actually let's put it like user, like that, and let's say it is user, and here let's say that it is user. Okay, it was an error because of our import. So on our user.js we need to put namespaced true. This will basically register our module with all of our module states, for example, and mutations, actions, we are going to have a namespace of user slash, for example, is logged in or something like that. This is useful because on the store, everything needs to be unique. So, for example, if we have an action called login, we can't have another action called login unless it is namespace. So, for example, user slash login, client slash login, admin slash login, something like that. Okay, so let's do that. And on our user.js, we have our store. Cool. We could test this out. For example, let's go to our login view, for example. And here on created, we can access our store on any component that is mounted by our application. So for example, we have this, let's console log, this dot dollar store dot state. Let's open the console and let's go to login page. Okay, so we have our console log with user and this logged in and user details. For example, we need to create, like I said, on our login.view, this action login user should be handled by our actions, store actions. So for example, we need to create, instead of this axios here, we should have this $store.dispatch. We can dispatch actions by this, and let's say it is log in or login user, and we should send the payload with this dot user. Of course, this action does not exist, so we need to create it. So let's cut this axios call and let's go to our user.js, and here on actions, let's say it is a login user action, and this one takes a context and a payload. Context is basically our store and with all of its methods. So let's say that it is a return new promise, or we could just, let's return new promise, which takes a method of resolve and reject, of course. Let me wrap that. And let's say it is resolve and reject. Okay. And let's put our axios and let's say it is a return. Actually a resolve of that. So axios. We need to import axios here. And let's say it is import axios from axios. For the moment, we are going to use the default instance of axios. So we have our resolve, and after local storage set item token response data, instead of this dot router push dashboard, because we don't have this dot dollar router anymore, we should put that on our component. Let me close this notification. Okay, so we are still storing our set token, but we need to use, instead of this dot user, we should use our payload. So it is payload, it should be payload, my bad, it is a mistype there. Okay, so we need to first of all call context that we can call mutations by committing. So context.commit, and it takes the exactly the property name, so it is set logged in, and it takes a payload which is true because we did login right now. So context.commit set logged in true, and we need to resolve something to have on our component. So for example, we could resolve our response even though we don't need it, and we could just catch what we have here. So for example, we have our error, but we are not going to, well, we could use our error here. And let's say we reject error. And let's put semicolon here. Okay, so back to on our login.view component. Since we are turning a promise right now, we could just add a dot then. And here, let's check the response. It should be the same response. Let's check it out. And Axios is defined but, but never used on our login component, of course. So we have still have our console log from our created. So let's say Peter at programmingwithpeter.com or Peter2. And let's say password. We're getting an error because can't property then of undefined. Oh, login user, since we put our namespaced modules, right now, instead of login user, it should be user slash login user. Because that's the name of our property. So if you go to store slash index.js, we have user key that is the namespace name. And let's try again. So let's say Peter at programmingwithpeter.com and password. And we are receiving our request. And of course we have our response.data. And if you refresh the page now, we are logged in. That means that our store method, it is working and it's all right. So we have a user slash login user with this user and we are console long. What we did is that we have our redirect. So if actually since it is a then, we could just do this dot dollar router dot push and we have the name dashboard of course. And we are not using the response anymore, so we could do just that. Refreshing the page, let's hit logout because it is still working. And we have Peter at programmingwithpeter.com and password. Let's log in and it is working. So right now we have on our state. Let's check if you have the view installed, the view extension installed, of course. Let's check out user slash set logged in and we have the state with true. This means that on our layout, so for example on our app.view, we have this if logged in. Well, we could just take that from the state now. So let's say that we have our a computed property. Let's make a getter because we forgot to make a getter on our user.js. We don't have getters. So let's make getters equals a new object. My bad. A new object with, let's say, logged in. Which is a method that takes the state. And let's say it is a return state that is logged in. And of course use it on our object that we export. Going back to app.view, we have our state here. Let's make a computed property. Computed. And here let's say that it is logged in. Is return this dot dollar store dot getters and of course it is a key, so we have user slash is logged in. Because it is namespaced, we have the namespace user slash is logged in or logged in. I forgot the name. Let's go back to our user.js and it is logged in, not is logged in. Okay, so user slash logged in. Let's check out, since we have our logged in state, let's check it out if it changes. For example, we refresh the page. Let's clear our storage, so application, let's clear the storage. Let's refresh the page. And of course we are redirector, so peter@programmingwithpeter.com and password, logging in. Right now we are logged in. If we hit logout, of course we don't have the state change of on our logout, but this means that on our app layout we have logged in through, which is alright. That's okay, we are taking it from our store. So basically on app.view we could just use this getter, and we are doing it. We don't have this is logged in anymore, so we could just comment this out. Of course we are going to commit, actually make an action that sets the store. So let's go to our user.js and let's make a new action that does logout, because we have the logout function. So let's hit logout user, and this takes a payload of course and a context, and returns a new promise. And here let's say that we have to delete that, of course. So let's do something like local storage. Let's go and copy our logic from our app.view, and we have our logout, and let's copy this remove item. But we don't have to do just that. Right now we have our logged in state that we need to change. So basically we have context.commit, and since we have that context.commit, we need to set logged in. Since we are inside this module, we don't have to put the namespace user slash, but if we are on another module we should do that. So set logged in, and we need to have a false, and let's resolve true. We don't actually use the payload, so we don't really care about it, and we are not using the reject to either. Okay, so logout user, let's go to our app.view, and on logout let's say that we have this dot $store.dispatch user slash logout user, and we have our then. So since we are returning a promise, we could do just then after the method it is done, the action, we redirect back to login view. So refreshing the page, let's try again. So peter@programmingwithpeter.com and password, login, we have our logout button, hitting logout, it's not anymore, and on register either of course. So going back to login, we have peter@programmingwithpeter.com and password, logging in, we have our button. We have an issue here, and that is of refreshing the page, since the state is not persisted. But we are not going to do that right now. Of course we are going to, for example, check on our, make an action that we execute here. But I want to show you something better. If you see here, this store dispatch is pretty ugly and a lot of text, let's say. So vuex have some helpers that are called mappers. Let's import them. So for example, for actions we have map action. Let's import the map actions from vuex. So on our login.view we have our map actions, and on methods we could just destructure this map actions. That so we need an object. Let's put the comma. Okay, so we have our, let's say, store or login, let's say that it is user slash login user. And right now we have our method here locally declared on this component, and we could just use it like this dot login, and takes as param this.user. So let's comment this out for the moment and let's check it out. Let's go back to our dashboard. Of course, we don't have the logout button anymore, so we need to clear the storage and refresh the page. So Peter at programmingwithpeter.com and password. Let's check the network and it is working. This means that our mapper is working. So let's remove this dispatch because this is the way to use vuex store on components, since we don't have to type this the dollar store. So map actions login. Let's go and let's remove this created because we don't need it anymore. Okay, so seems like that. Let's go to app.view and do the same thing. So we have our getter and we have a getter mapper too. So let's say that it is import map getters from vuex. My bad. So here we could just use, for example, the structure map getters that is the same as map actions. It takes an array or an object. We are going to use objects because we need it for our namespaced modules. So let's say it is logged in, the key, and user slash login, logged in, sorry. And right now we have our computed property declared. So let's check it out. Let's go to Peter at programmingwithpeter.com and it's not showing anymore, of course, the bottom, and it is working. So we have less to type right now. And let's do the same with map actions for our logout user. So let's say that it is map actions. Not sure if it is imported and it is not. So map actions. It takes an object as a param. And it is just logout user, let's say. My bad. And user slash logout user. And right now, instead of this dispatch, let's do this dot logout user. And that's it. Let's check it out. So we have our user. I think it refreshed anyway, but let's check it out again. So we have our user and logout. That's working. My bad. So basically right now we have vuex on our stores. Let's make another action because it annoys me. So let's say it is store.view. We don't actually need to have actions just for like I showed. We don't have just to send requests. We could just change the state and that's it. But we change the state via commit, not on directly on action. That's the practice. So let's make another action that sets the logged in state. Let's make another action. Let's say that it set logged in state and takes a context. And of course, just that, because we are going to check on our if we have get item of local storage. So let's return a new promise. I like to return promises because I can wait for them to finish, even if it's not something async. Resolve, reject. And here we have our context. Let's resolve. Actually, let's say context.commit. Set logged in. True. Actually, set logged in only if local storage dot remove, actually dot get item of token. My bad. We have this context commit set logged in true. If we have something on our token, else set logged in false. So we have set logged in state false. So get item token, set logged in true, set logged in false. And let's resolve with something. So let's say resolve true and resolve false. We don't need the reject here. So set logged in. Okay, let's remove this comment here. Let's use set this new action on our app.view. So on our app.view, instead of checking directly here, we could just either do this dot dollar store or just map our action. So we have our for example check user state, for example, and it is user slash, let's go again to user.js, set logged in state. So right now when our created, we have our method, so this dot check user state. And it is a method, of course. So basically right now we have our method, and let's say peter@programmingwithpeter.com and password login. We had the bug that on refresh the logout button disappears because we don't have our state reset. We have our state resetted, of course, but since we are checking the state on refresh right now on created of our app.view, which is the root component, this is not happening anymore. So let's commit our changes. This is looking all right for the moment. So let's commit our changes. And let's say that we have create, or actually add user vuex store. Create user vuex store methods. Let's say actions, getters, and mutations, and implement map getters and map actions for user out. Let's commit our changes. Okay, guys, so that's it for today. I don't want to go in deeper because we need to implement some backend methods. So thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this kind of videos, please subscribe, leave a like, maybe comment, and let's see each other on the next one.